Overnight, Buckingham Palace finally issued a response to claims made in that bombshell interview, saying the whole family is saddened to learn the full extent of how challenging the last few years have been for Harry and Meghan. It went on to say that the issues raised, particularly that of race, are concerning and will be addressed by the family privately. And while the royal family has chosen to address the crisis privately, the British press has been having a much more public reckoning.
It was a toddler-grade dummy spit.
OK, I'm done with this.
No.
Sorry, no.
And after tens of thousands of complaints, Piers Morgan kept on walking.
Sorry, can't
this
do this.
This is absolutely diabolical.
Right out of his job as head of Good Morning Britain, all because of this truth bomb.
And I understand that you've got a personal relationship with Meghan Markle, or had one, and she cut you off. She's entitled to cut you off if she wants to. Has she said anything about you since she cut you off? I don't think she has, but yet you continue to trash her.
And the internet has the receipts from Morgan's Daily Mail hate campaign.
Meghan Kardashian Markle.
A ruthless social climbing actress who has landed the role of her life, determined to milk it for all it's worth.
Self-indulgent.
Playing the victim.
Me, Meghan's shamelessly hypocritical, super woke Vogue stunt.
The public will never respect you like they respect the Queen.
But that's one down, an entire industry to go. Throughout that interview, Harry and Meghan's fear and loathing of the British media machine was unmistakable.
But I also am acutely aware of where my family stand and how scared they are of the tabloids turning on them.
They really seem to want a narrative of a hero and a villain.
See if you can pick which one's which.
Our experts reveal the Duchess of Cambridge's secrets to looking sizzling.
My memo to Meghan Markle. We Brits prefer true royalty to fashion royalty.
Pregnant Kate tenderly cradles her baby bump.
Why can't Meghan Markle keep her hands off her bump?
Kate's morning sickness cure? William gifted with avocado for pregnant Duchess.
Meghan Markle's beloved avocado linked to human rights abuse and drought.
That's a really loaded piece of toast.
But there was a sinister side too.
Kate was called Waity Katie, waiting to marry William. We've all had to deal with things that are rude. Rude and racist are not the same.
Did you leave the country because of racism?
It was a large part of it. I remember that the Centre Bali fundraiser.
Yes.
One of the people at that dinner said to me, please don't do this with the media. They will destroy your life.
Perversely, in helping to drive the Sussexes out of Britain and into Oprah's arms, the tabloids got what they crave most: more drama, more scandal, and more fuel for the furnace.
They don't report the news, they create the news.
Well, for more on the Royal Rift, we cross now to London to catch up with Lucy McDonald. Luce, there's a lot of talk about the fact that the media victimised Meghan. Why do you think they did that? And do you think that they did treat Meghan and Kate very differently?
Well, I think that the media has traditionally treated all spouses and girlfriends of any royal, really, in an absolutely appalling manner. I mean, Diana was hounded, Fergie was ridiculed, you know, Waity Katie was, you know, people really, the press really laid into her. But with Meghan, it felt more sinister. I definitely feel that it was her dual heritage. The fact that she was an independent woman who spoke her mind, who was used to, there was that great line in the interview, wasn't it? It was, I've been a waitress, I've been an actress, I've been a duchess, I've been a princess. And I just don't think they like that. But yes, they felt like they were always these very, very, she's not one of us kind of tone to the piece, to many of the pieces. They didn't like her because she didn't know her place. And I guess unless you're British or you really understand the British class system, it's rife. And people, the establishment doesn't like people who step out of their boundaries. And Meghan did that. Self-made woman, dual heritage, an American coming here and marrying a British prince. There was a lot for people not to like, I suppose. When I say people, I mean the press, I mean the editors, I mean the establishment. I think most normal people really like Meghan, actually.
Lucy, the Queen's statement was a very short 61 words. Was that enough?
So I think it conveyed a lot. It certainly conveyed that the royal family believes there's two sides to every story. Of course, there is. And although it acknowledged race, it didn't acknowledge racism. So it was a very careful statement. It felt to me a little bit like, sorry, but one of those kind of sort of half-hearted apologies. But there was warmth in it as well. I felt that came from the Queen. That might be my personal opinion. But those hoping for a sort of out-and-out apology and investigation will be very much disappointed. The Queen obviously wants to close ranks and keep things firmly within the family.
One of the things that Lizzie did state was that some recollections may vary. Is that proper English for Meghan's a liar, bro?
I love the fact you're on first name terms with Lizzie. Well, it's unclear what that phrase refers to. You know, perhaps the remarks over Archie's skin colour or the protocol, whether it was changed to deny, you know, Archie the title of prince when Charles becomes king, or was it around Meghan's mental health? But it's certainly throwing shade on Harry and Meghan, and it's certainly seeding doubt about whether their interview was entirely true, I suppose. Although I think body language experts have looked at Meghan's body language in that interview, and they do say she was telling the truth. So, you know, I guess truth is subjective.
Sorry to laugh at that. I just find that body language experts, those ones, yeah.
Well, it depends who's paying to.
Yeah, they had a couple of tarot card readers have a look at it as well. And she's telling the truth. You know?
Hey, Elise, can we talk Piers Morgan for a sec? He's a TV institution in the UK. He walked off Good Morning Brit this morning. He is outski, but he's just tweeted this. He tweeted, "On Monday, I said I didn't believe Meghan Markle in her Oprah interview. I've had time to reflect on this opinion, and I still don't. If you did, okay, freedom of speech is a hill I'm happy to die on. Thanks for all the love and hate. I'm off to spend more time with my opinions," which is very Piers. What's been the reaction over there? How are you feeling about it?
Well, Piers Morgan is certainly a very divisive character. Personally, I'm not a fan of someone who's like this anti-woke warrior. Don't forget he was a friend of Trump. He's actually been amazing journalistically on COVID. He's been really calling the government to account. But his reaction around Meghan Markle has been extraordinary. They were friends. She appears to have ghosted him. And he's just been very vindictive, borderline obsession, saying that, you know, it didn't look like she was suffering. I find that very, very hard to stomach. So I think he had to go. I think ITV bosses were right. He's not going into the abyss, though. There are two new television stations being launched here shortly. Some people are saying they're going to be kind of like a bit like Fox, America's Fox News. He's obviously got, I think, nearly 8 million followers on Twitter. So, yeah, he's going to still very much be part of the national conversation. Will I miss him?
No. What's the body language expert saying there,
Andy? My body language expert. I'm reading between the lines, and I'm with you.
Well, it's put me off. I've made a decision. I'm not going to be marrying into the royal family. You've heard that statement here for the first time, but I intend to stick with it. Lucy, thanks for your insight.
Thank you.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.